Now let us discuss the load related to critical angle. Already we know that the relation between critical angle and apparent radiuses of two media means a denser medium and rarer medium. What is that relation? Relation between critical angle and refractive index of the both media means denser medium and rarer medium. So what is that relation? Yesterday we derived that. That is sin c is equal to n2 by n1. What is n2 here? n2 is nothing but it is the refractive index of rarer medium and n1 is the refractive index of denser medium. Am I right? Sin c is equal to n2 is refractive index of rarer medium. Because second medium is rarer medium, first medium is denser medium, because the light traveling from first medium to second medium means denser medium to rarer medium. So it is a refractive index of rarer medium divided by refractive index of denser medium. So it is the relation between critical angle and refractive indexes of both media. Then next, what is the relation between critical angle and the speeds of light in both media? Relation between critical angle and speed means the speeds of light in both media. Already we know that is m2 by m1 is equal to V1 by V2. Why? Because here the refractive index and the speed of the light both are inversely related. So the speed of light in second medium is V2 and the speed of refractive index of the second medium is N2. And the speed of light in first medium is V1 and the refractive index of the first medium is N1. They are inversely related. Okay. So I will write this equation as sin C is equal to in sine of critical angle is equal to that is V1 by V2. Then what is V1? V1 is that it is a speed of light in denser medium. Because which is the first medium here? Denser medium is the first medium. So speed of light in denser medium. Speed of light in denser medium divided by speed of light in rarer medium. Speed of light in rarer medium. Because second medium is the rarer medium, the speed of light in second medium is taken as V2 here. That is why the speed of light in rarer medium, because in case of total internal reflection, the second medium is rarer medium and first medium is denser medium. Always, the speed of light in denser medium is less than the speed of light in rarer medium. Why? Because here, the speed of light in rarer medium is higher than the speed of light in denser medium. Okay. So, when the light enters the rarer medium, the speed of light increases. But in the denser medium, its speed is minimum. When it enters the rarer medium, its speed increases. So, here, sin C. And one more thing remember here. Here, V1 is less than V2. V1 is less than V2. It is very important. So, means the speed of light in rarer medium is greater than speed of light in denser medium. Because in this denser medium, the speed of light is minimum. And in the rarer medium, the speed of light is maximum. That is why V1 is less than V2. 1 stands for a denser medium and 2 stands for a rarer medium. And also we are going to write the critical angle in terms of wavelength. Relation between critical angle. Relation between critical angle and wavelength. It is a third one. Okay. So, what is that relation? Once again. So, N2 by N1 is equal to V1 by V2. Then V1 by V2 is equal to lambda 1 by lambda 2. Because speed and wavelength both are directly proportional. So, sin of C is equal to N2 by N1. N2 by N1 means here it is lambda 1 by lambda 2. Lambda 1 by lambda 2. What is lambda 1? Lambda 1 is the wavelength of light in the denser medium. Okay, it is a minimum wavelength, means it is a, the wavelength is minimum in the denser medium. And what is lambda 2 here? It is the wavelength of light in rarer medium. Okay, so wavelength of light in rarer medium is maximum and the wavelength of light in denser medium is minimum. So, lambda 1 can be written as wavelength of light. Wavelength of light in denser medium. In denser medium. Wavelength of light in denser medium. Wavelength of light in denser medium. To the divided by wavelength of light in rarer medium. So in which medium the wavelength of light is maximum? In which medium the speed of light is maximum? Okay. So in which medium the speed of light is maximum? In rarer medium. So that is why always lambda 2 is greater than lambda 1, means lambda 1 is less than lambda 2. Here lambda 1 is less than lambda 2. 1 stands for here denser medium, 2 stands for here rarer medium. In the denser medium the wavelength of light is minimum and in the rarer medium the wavelength of light is maximum, because speed and wavelength both are directly related. Okay, so this is about the note related to relation between critical angle, refractive index, speed and also. So next we are going to discuss about the word seen by the fish, and it is a neat application. So how will be the fish see the outer world? So fish inside the water, how it will see the outer world? So first we have to draw the diagram. Now let us consider, it is the surface of water. There is a fish inside the water. The light traveling from water to air. So, if the incident ray is incident at an angle equal to critical angle on the water and air interface, the refracted ray grazes along its surface. With an angle how much? The angle of refraction becomes how much? 90 degree. Okay, up to this much refraction of light will be takes place. Up to this point the refraction of light will be takes place. When the incident ray reaches this point, there is a refraction of light takes place along the surface. If there is a further increase in angle of incidence, the light is completely reflected in the water medium. Okay, so next, here also the light traveling from which medium to which medium? Denser medium to rarer medium. Here denser medium is water. I will take refractive index of denser medium as m, and the refractive index of rarer medium is 1, because first medium is water, second medium is air, the refractive index of air is how much? 1. So if the angle of incidence is equal to critical angle, then the refracted ray grazes along the surface here. So up to this point the light emerges out through the air. Okay. So what is the world seen by the fish here? The outer world seen by the fish through the inverted cone. This is the inverted cone, and base of the inverted cone is circular. Base of the inverted cone is circular. So we are going to find this base, means area of this base, and also radius of this base. Then at what distance fish is there from the surface of water, that is called depth of the fish from the surface of water, that is h. Okay, so now if it is c, now this is also c because they are alternate angles, it is also c. Okay, so c plus c, it is a 2c. Then what is the depth of the fish from the surface of water, means height of the fish from the surface of the water, that can be taken as h. And radius of the circular base of the cone, that is r, and its diameter is 2r. Okay, next, how to derive the expression for radius of the circular base of the cone seen by the fish? Then, so a fish is at a distance, a fish is at a distance of h from the surface of water, from the surface of water, of refractive index L, of refractive index L. So in some books it will be take mu. Don't confuse it that mu and L stands for a refractive index. So of refractive index L, can see the outer world, can see the outer world through inverted cone, through inverted cone, inverted cone. So this is called inverted cone, and it is the base of the inverted cone. Base of the inverted cone is circular. Then next, what we have to find radius of the circular base of the inverted cone. Radius of circular base. Radius of circular base of inverted cone. Cone will be, how to determine that one? We have to find the radius. How to find the radius here? By using the tan function. So why we have to use the tan function here? Tan function is nothing but opposite side divided by adjacent side. What is opposite side here? Opposite side is radius. And what is adjacent side here? That is the depth of the fish from the surface of water, that is h. Now it is a fish. Okay. Then what about radius now? How to find radius here? By using tan function, tan c is equal to opposite side is radius, then adjacent side is depth of the fish from the surface of water, that is h. Then r is equal to h into tan c. So what about tan c? We have to find the tan c. How to find the tan c in terms of refractive index? So tan is nothing but sine by cos. So that is h sine c divided by cos c. Sin c divided by cos c. Already we know that what is sin c? Sin c is nothing but 1 by m. Relation between critical angle and refractive index. Sin c is equal to m2 by n1. n1 is the refractive index of denser medium, and n2 is the refractive index of rarer medium. Remember this one in case of critical angle. So first medium is the denser and second medium is the rarer. What is the refractive index of rarer medium here? 1, because rarer medium is A, and the refractive index of denser medium I will take, that is N, that is 1 by N. Sin C means here 1 by N. Then what about cos C? Cos C is equal to square root of 1 minus of sin square C. 1 minus of sin square C. By using the formula, sin square C plus cos square C is equal to 1. Then cos square c is equal to 1 minus of sin square c, but cos c is equal to square root of 1 minus sin square c. Then, so what about 1 minus sin square c here? 1 minus 1 by n square, because sin c is nothing but 1 by n, but its square is there, that is 1 by n square. Then take the LCM. So LCM is n square, then n square minus of 1, then square root of n square minus of 1 divided by square root of n square is n. Square root of n square is n, because square root square get cancelled. Then I will write here r is equal to h into sin c is nothing but by using these terms. Yeah, sin c is nothing but 1 by n divided by, what about cos c? That is square root of n square minus of 1 divided by n. So 1 by n, so 1 by n get cancelled. What left now? That is r is equal to h by square root of n square minus of 1. It is the formula used to find the radius of the circular base of the cone seen by the fish. Then what is the formula used to find the area? Area. How to find the area here? Area of the circular base of the inverted cone seen by the fish. If depth of the fish from the surface of water given and refractiveness of the water given, find the radius by using this formula. Next one, area of the circular base. Area of the circular base of the inverted cone. Inverted cone is, already we know that what is the expression for area of the circle, that is pi r square. A is equal to pi r square. Then what about r here? R is given here. So r is pi into h by square root of n square minus of 1 whole square, because r square is there. Then pi into h square divided by square of square we get cancel, we will get it is n square minus of 1. It is the direct formula used to find the area of the circular base of the inverted cone seen by the fish. Then how will be the fish see the outer world here? Through the inverted cone, and here up to this much, throughout this area light emerges out. Okay, because up to this much refraction of light takes place. So when the angle of incidence reaches the critical angle, there is no further refraction of light, there is only total internal reflection of light. So this is about world seen by the fish, and you have to remember these two formulae are very important to find the radius of the circular base of the cone seen by the fish and to find its area. Okay, so now we are going to solve some NEET numerical related to the world seen by the fish. But this problem is just similar to the word seen by the fish. Already we know that what is the expression for area of the circular base of the cone here. That is A equal to pi into h square divided by square root of n square minus of 1. By using that formula we are going to solve this problem. A small bulb is placed at the bottom of tank. Let us take it is a tank. A small bulb is placed at the bottom of tank containing water to a depth of 80 cm. At what depth water is there? That is at 80 cm. So next, what is the area of the surface of water through which light from the bulb can be emerged? So I will take here the light incident at the interface between water and air. With an angle is equal to critical angle, the light reaches along the surface after refraction. Same here, if the light incident obliquely from water to air, if the angle of incidence is equal to critical angle, the refracted light reaches along the surface. So when it reaches the critical angle, there is no refraction of light, or there is only refraction of light along the surface. If there is a further increase in angle of incidence greater than critical angle, there is no refraction of light, there is only reflection of light in the denser medium. Means within this range the light can be absorbed, because within this range refraction of light will be takes place. Okay, so we have to find the area of this circular base. Area of the surface of the water we are going to find. How to find the area of the surface of the water? By using the formula, first we are going to write the given values. So depth of the water given and refractiveness of the water given. So what is the depth of the water? H, that is 80 centimeter. 80 centimeter means it is 80 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. Centimeter to meter, 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. And also refractiveness of water is given, that is how much? 1.33. Then we are going to find the area of the surface of water. Area of the surface of water. Area of the surface of water is A is equal to pi into h square divided by nw square minus of 1. So we derive this formula. Okay. So what is pi? Pi value is how much? Pi value is 3.14. Then h square means here 80 into 10 to the power of minus 2 whole square. So pi is 3.14. And h square means here, that is 80 into 10 to the power of minus 2 square divided by, it is 1.33 square minus of 1. So solve this one. So on solving this one, we will get the final answer, that is 2.61 meters square. So through this much area, the light can be absorbed. Okay, so this is the problem related to the as word seen by the fish.